Note: the following program should be distributed to the audience every time the Symphonie Fantastique is performed dramatically and thus followed by the monodrama of Lelio, which concludes and completes the episode in the life of an artist. In this case, the invisible orchestra is placed on the stage of a theater behind the lowered curtain. If the symphony is performed on its own as a concert piece, this arrangement is no longer necessary. One may even dispense with distributing the program and keep only the title of the five movements. The author hopes that the symphony provides on its own sufficient musical interest independent of any dramatic intention. Program of a symphony. A young musician of morbid sensitivity and ardent imagination poisons himself with opium in a moment of despair caused by frustrated love. The dose of narcotic, while too weak to cause his death, plunges him into a heavy sleep accompanied by the strangest of visions, in which his experiences, feelings and memories are translated in his feverish brain into musical thoughts and images. His beloved becomes for him a melody and like an idée fixe which he meets and hears everywhere. Part 1. Daydreams, passions. He remembers first the uneasiness of spirit, the indefinable passion, the melancholy, the aimless joys he felt even before seeing his beloved, then the explosive love she suddenly inspired in him, his delirious anguish, his fits of jealous fury, his returns of tenderness, his religious consolations. Part 2. A ball. He meets again his beloved in a ball during a glittering fete. Part 3. Scene in the countryside. One summer evening in the countryside, he hears two shepherds dialoguing with their rams devash this pastoral duet. The setting, the gentle rustling of the trees in the light wind, some causes for hope that he has recently conceived, all conspire to restore to his heart an unaccustomed feeling of calm and to give to his thoughts a happier coloring. But she reappears. He feels a pang of anguish, and painful thoughts disturb him. What if she betrayed him? One of the shepherds resumes his simple melody, the other one no longer answers. The sun sets, distant sound of thunder, solitude, silence. Part 4. March to the scaffold. He dreams that he has killed his beloved, that he is condemned to death and led to execution. The procession advances to the sound of a march that is sometimes somber and wild, and sometimes brilliant and solemn, in which a dull sound of heavy footsteps follows without transition the loudest outbursts. At the end, the idée fixe reappears for a moment like a final thought of love interrupted by the fatal blow. Part 5. Dream of a witch's Sabbath. He sees himself at a witch's Sabbath, in the midst of a hideous gathering of shades, sorcerers and monsters of every kind who have come together for his funeral. Strange sounds, groans, outbursts of laughter, distant shouts which seem to be answered by more shouts. The beloved melody appears once more, but has now lost its noble and shy character. It is now no more than a vulgar dance tune. Trivial and grotesque, it is she who is coming to the Sabbath. Roars of delight at her arrival, she joins the diabolical orgy. The funeral knell tolls, burlesque parody of the Désirée, the dance of the witches, the dance of the witches combined with the Désirée.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.